Welcome back to Arise and Shine. Alexander Bach became a viral sensation as Your Favorite Prankster went on YouTube. Then he took the Ellen DeGeneres Show Dance Challenge and ended up dancing his way into trouble with the police. The question is, did he do anything wrong? Alexander is here to tell us what happened, but first, let's watch a portion of the video that went viral.
No, I'm just dancing.
What are you doing behind?
No, I'm dancing. Kidding me? What's wrong with you?
What are you dancing in the street for?
Dancing in the street in front of us.
Put your hands away, bro.
Wow, welcome, Alexander, right?
I don't know what to say after that video.
I know, right? Did you know that video was going to go viral?
Never. I never expected that video would go all the way to 800,000 views in 6-7 days.
Wow. Do you think it had anything to do with the recent events
here in the city? Yes, sadly, I think yes. I wasn't really, that wasn't in my head.
Right.
Really matching those events and everything. All I was thinking is really just to go do the Ellen Day dance.
Right.
And that's it.
So why don't you explain to us the challenge, by the way, for people who don't know about why you exactly were dancing in the street.
All right. So basically the challenge is simple. You go behind strangers and you just dance without them knowing it.
Okay.
And
that sounds fun.
Supposed to know.
That sounds like Jonathan.
Sounds like Jonathan and I.
Yeah, sorry.
That's it. Just dancing, having fun, and because it's fun to watch, like somebody's dancing behind somebody and they don't really know it, so it's kind of fun.
Yeah,
right. I think it's fun. So what was your reaction on Christmas Eve to what happened?
My reaction?
Yes.
Honestly, my reaction was, like, I was shocked. The entire day was fun.
Right.
Because I was like, in my head, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm going to do this amazing video. Like, I had a Gangnam Style music in my head.
Right.
It's going to be amazing.
It was amazing, by the way.
And after that, I was shocked.
Right.
Yes.
I was shocked. I was confused. I had to go to a movie after. I spent the entire movie having this scene in my head.
Yeah, right. I bet it was.
Because they pushed you down.
Yeah, and it's my first time. Like, I'm a good guy.
Yes.
I never, 22 years old, never got in trouble with any cops in my entire life.
Right.
So that first thing got me really, really shocked.
And, you know, some people might say that you were pushing the envelope a little bit, especially given, as Rain pointed out, that there's been so many recent incidents. Mm-hmm. Just a few days before, there had been those NYPD officers who had been killed. Mm-hmm. I mean, what would you say to people who think that you maybe were trying to push people's buttons?
I was not trying to push any envelope. All I was doing is just dancing behind people, because in my head is the Ellen Day dance, it's only in December.
Right.
It's 25th. Right. So I'm like, let's go and do the dance.
Yeah.
And when I saw the cop, for me, like, NYPD is what? NYPD is the symbol of New York in the entire world. So I'm like, I'm going to have one NYPD dancing behind him, put it in the video, and it's going to be amazing New York City. I never thought.
Right.
Right.
So I was just dancing. I was not, because some people think I was maybe like trying to do it on purpose 4 days after those cops got killed. But that was not my intention.
Right. You had a positive intention. And that seems to be the premise for a lot of what you do.
Yeah. So, like, let's back up a second. This dance thing wasn't your first sort of prank, I guess you can say. You kind of call yourself a prankster, and you started this prankster channel.
I'm the favorite prankster.
Yeah, I love it. You're my favorite prankster, for sure. But you started this YouTube channel, the Prankster Channel. Tell us a little bit about that, like, why you started it.
Right. Because the reason why I started the Prankster Channel is just to change the world. My goal is to make a better world. Because if you see, like, around the world, there's so much negativity, so much hate, so much people going into wrong direction, doing crazy things. My goal is just to create a channel, like youtube.com/thealexanderbach. They go to that channel and they feel happy. Like, after a bad day or crazy thing that happened to them, they just go inside and they feel really, like, really joy and everything. I just want to make people feel good. That's it.
Which is...
You're like that Pharrell happy video.
Happy video. Yeah. I can be that guy.
So what has made you decide to do that?
What, on the YouTube channel?
No, to be this guy that wants to spread the happiness, that wants to be the prankster.
Yeah, because in my life, like, I had really, like, I had many, many bad things happening to me.
Okay.
And I, like, after a lot, like, I read a lot of books and stuff, and I understood how the world was going, because the way the world is going is all negativity and depression.
Right.
So it came to my mind, just boom, I have to do it. And yeah, YouTube excellent. Is so powerful. It's more powerful than TV.
It's true. Right. Everyone's on YouTube.
Totally agree.
And so I mean, the fact that your video went viral is so cool. Well, I think
we have some clips.
Yeah, let's check out some of your other videos.
Guess what? New York City is so stressful. So today, guys, we're going to ask New Yorkers to help you to fight, right?
Yes.
Random happiness. It's so beautiful. Have you ever received other negative responses like you did from the NYPD that day?
Never. Like, the worst I had is somebody just walking away, like that pillow fight that you said.
Right, the pillow fight. Well, that's as bad as it gets. That's awesome.
But I love that that's, like, so New York City that you were even able to find someone dressed up as, what, Spider-Man and get into a pillow fight with him?
Great.
I mean,
yeah,
really,
crazy.
You can't make this stuff up. And I also love the dramatic music. It makes it so much more intense, I think. Well, so tell us a little bit about your background, because you have a really interesting story. Where are you from originally?
Okay, I'm from Burkina Faso.
Okay.
It's a really small country in Africa. And my mom is from Ukraine.
Oh, wow.
So that's the kind of like...
And so when did you come to the United States? Why did you come here? And, you know, what were your goals?
My goal is to come to New York City, to the USA. It's the American dream.
Yeah.
Right.
My goal is really to be like the next big thing, more than Elvis Presley or Michael Jackson. I just want to be the next big superstar.
Just spreading love or
exactly.
doing an actual thing? Just spreading love?
Yeah,
that's awesome.
Yeah, basically just spreading love, joy, and like have people just enjoying their life, like just
but
enjoy the best time of their life.
What I think is the most inspirational thing about your story too is that you struggled when you first came here, right? I mean, tell us about that and how are you able to stay so positive and now turn all of that negativity and the struggles into spreading this love and happiness like Rain was talking about?
True, when I came to New York City, you know, like coming from a small country to that big, fast-paced environment, first it was hard. Like when you're alone, don't know anybody, it was every day it was a struggle just to keep myself up. But after like getting into all the struggles, I met many good friends, many good people, many good teachers, people that inspired me a lot. So that's what really brought me to just not focus on the bad things. Just when you focus on the good, you end up going to the good.
Right, that's your intention's good. You're like the Anthony Robbins of like a younger generation, by the way.
I love that guy.
I bet you do.
Amazing.
And Wayne Dwyer and all of them. I can see it. So what kind of reaction did you get for the Ellen video?
It was 50-50. Like really thank you for all those people, because I had a 50-50. Many people like send me all good messages of love, support, but I also have like people sending me like hate messages,
of course,
death threat, and people who wanted the cop even to shoot me or stuff. So like in the beginning it's hard, like when you're new to that stuff, getting all those hate messages every day on your Facebook, YouTube. It's hard
in
the beginning.
But you take that intention that you're practicing and you shoot it all away.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You send it up in good light.
Yeah, I'm just good. You know? Good vibes, that's it.
That's right.
So
good vibes.
The $1 million question is, have you heard from Ellen?
No.
Hi, Ellen. I'm sure she's watching right now. She's going to call you after this. No, but have you?
You never know. She might.
No, really.
Yes.
If Ellen is watching, I'm coming to Ellen. Like, I didn't
Here, look at the camera and what would you like to say to Ellen?
Okay, Ellen.
you didn't contact me yet, but I'm coming for you.
And he means that in a positive way.
In right, a positive yeah. way. I'm not going to call him doing bad things. No.
Just want to clarify.
Spread the love
right,
to you.
Spreading love, right.
I love it. So your most recent incident isn't obviously going to stop you from doing
no.
more. What? Right. How do you come up with your ideas of what you're going to do? You yeah. know, I mean, the pillow fight, that was cool.
Oh,
but
you know,
do you have anything that you can preview us with that we might see you on the streets of New York? I mean,
right.
first of
I'm
all, kidding. If you see me on the streets of New York, I hope you bring me a rose.
Right. I will love it.
I would definitely
oh my God,
bring
I
you
think,
a rose.
Oh, if I knew, next time, I'm going to bring yeah. two roses.
Okay,
yes.
good.
Thank you.
But do you have, like,
so what's your next
yeah,
thing?
What's your next thing?
Because, like, Ellen didn't contact me yet.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
So,
she will, don't worry.
So, no, so right now, I'm not stopping. Like, on Tuesday, I have mm-hmm. another video about Ellen, like another shocking video about Ellen.
Excellent. Gonna go for it.
Tuesday.
All right. Well, all right, stay Tuesday tuned. Everybody should go to his YouTube page to find out what it is. I definitely will on
I
Tuesday.
Know, right?
Well, thank you, Alexander. You can find your favorite prankster videos at youtube.com/ the Alexander Bach. And definitely let us know if you do hear from Ellen,
awesome.
By the way. Well, up next, the Sony hacking has been in the headlines on a daily basis. Is North Korea really behind the cyber invasion? Davin Rosenblatt will join us to help investigate the facts and find out who's vulnerable to similar cyber attacks. Don't go away, you're watching Arise and Shine.